Hi everyone, myself Jay Shree and I belong to a Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering of Rajagiri School of Engineering and Technology. Today's topic is based on servo motor. Actually, the lecture is divided into two. This is my first lecture on the topic servo motor, followed by the second one, and that too framed for EE216 Electrical Engineering for Applied Electronics and Instrumentation 4th semester students. So, the contents, today we'll be discussing about servo motor introduction, requirements for a good servo motor, and actually servo motors are classified into two, AC servo motors and DC servo motors. And in this lecture, I'll be discussing more on AC servo motor, its construction, working principle, applications, and we'll see the relevance of closed loop control system. Now we'll see what a servo motor is. Servo motor is a rotary, or it can either be a rotary or linear actuator that allows for precise control of angular or linear position, velocity and acceleration. We'll be discussing about rotary actuator type servo motors. A servo motor is an electromechanical device which can rotate or place an object at some specific angles or distance with great precision. Designed to use in motion control applications which require high accuracy positioning, quick reversing and exceptional performance as for robotics. Unlike large industrial motors, a servo motor is not used for continuous energy conversion like stepper motor. Servo motor is a simple motor which run through servo mechanism. What is servo mechanism? A mechanism which uses position feedback to control the speed and final position of the motor. A servo system combines a motor, feedback circuit, controller and other electronic circuits. Towards the end, we'll be discussing such a system. Now, servo motors are also called as control motors, as they are involved in controlling a mechanical system. Two types are there, AC servo motor and DC servo motors. AC servo motors are generally suitable for low power applications. Some of the advantages behind AC servo motor: low cost, rugged construction, more reliable when compared to DC servos, less maintenance required but more complex. Since control system is cheaper, AC servo motor is more popular than DC servo motors. Now, DC servo motors suitable for high power application, generally above 100 watts. Now, there are some requirements for good servo motor, whether it is AC servo motor or DC servo motor. Linear relationship between electrical control signal and robot speed, rotor speed over a wide range. Inertia motor should be as small as possible. That is, the motor should stop running without any time delay if control signal is removed. For low inertia, the rotor should be built with large length to diameter ratio. Rotor of a servo motor has a very small diameter. Servo motor is distinguished by small diameter. It should be quickly reversible. Now, response should be very fast by keeping torque to weight ratio high. Starting or stopping can be done quickly. Should have linear torque speed characteristic, very essential. Output torque at any speed should be roughly proportional to the output applied control signal, and stable operation without oscillations or overshoot is mandatory for a good servo motor. Now we'll be concentrating on AC servo motors. AC servo motor is basically a two-phase induction motor type for low power application, but three-phase type is also present. Recently, three-phase squirrel cage induction motors have been modified for application in high power servo system. But we'll be discussing about the two-phase AC servo motor in detail. Now, the rotor of the AC servo is generally squirrel cage. Should be built with high resistance so that X by R ratio is small, leading to linear torque speed characteristics. And for comparison, I have taken the torque speed characteristics of a servo motor as well as induction motor. Servo motor should have small XBR ratio, while the commercial or ordinary induction motor have large XBR ratio. So this is the one for servo motor. This is the one required. Now, the stator can, similar to any rotating machine, it should have a stator and rotor. And the stator can be arranged in two fashions. One similar to that of stator motor, a stepper motor, or otherwise it can be similar to an induction motor. Now, in the case of the first case, it consists of two salient poles, AB, look at the diagram, AB and CD, mount on the inner periphery of a stator. And this looks similar to that of the stator of a stepper motor. But the specialty is that their axis should be 90 degree apart in space. So AB forms a face and CD forms another face. They should be apart by 90 degree. Each pole pair carries a winding. You can see A and B constitute a pair and that carries a winding called a face. One called the reference or fixed face and the other is called the control face. Now you can see around the poles, you can see the winding and the exciting current through the winding should have a phase displacement of 90 degree and poles are of laminated nature. Now you can have the second type, the stator similar to that of three-phase induction motor which has a distributed winding. Now being a two-phase AC servo, it has got two distributed windings present in the inner periphery of the stator core. And the axis should be apart by 90 degrees. What's the need for 90 degrees in order to have a rotating magnetic field? One winding, similar to the previous case, one winding is called the reference phase or the fixed phase and the other is called the control phase. Now, the stator has to be fed with a voltage with a phase displacement of 90 degrees. Now, we'll see how it is done. The supply used to drive the motor a single phase. So in order to have 90 degree phase displacement, a capacitor can be connected to one of the phase. Generally, it is connected to the reference winding. The reference winding is supplied with a constant voltage source. Let us represent it as Vm angle 0. And the control winding is fed with a variable voltage of same frequency as reference, but with a phase displacement of 90. So you can write Va either plus angle 90 or VA angle minus 90. You should have a phase displacement of 90 degree lag or lead, generally supplied by a servo amplifier. And for 50 hertz applications, you are having 2 pole or 4 pole. And for above 400 hertz, you are having 400 hertz to 100 hertz, you will be having 10 poles. Now the types of rotor, you can have three configurations. First type, the standard squirrel cage rotor. So first type is the squirrel cage type, similar to your three-phase induction motor. It is the rotor is cylindrical in shape and that too thick. Rotor core made up of steel stampings, thin laminations, outer periphery slotted to accommodate thick copper bars and that of high resistance. And you have to maintain the XBR ratio small. High resistance means XBR ratio is small. Now, copper bars short circuited with end rings. Rotor windings are skewed by one or more slot to avoid a particular phenomenon called cogging caused by magnetic force of attraction. So, that's the first type. You can see the diagram. You can see the shaft. Rotor bars short circuited with end rings. Now, the second type, it can even be a solid iron type, the rotor. Rotor, shape of a cylinder and that with thin cylinder. No winding present on the rotor. Rotor made up of a material with good conductivity and magnetic permeability. Now the third type, which is commonly used, is drag cup servo motor. Here the specialty is that there is some difference in the construction of a stator also. You can see the diagram. So this represents the stator with winding. And the outer stator supported by the frame and it carries a winding. And you are having an inner core also supported by the frame but without winding that actually parts form part of a rotor. Both of cylindrical shape and made up of laminated steel. You can see the diagram. So this represents the stator with winding, and the rotor part, this is also a stationary part, and this represents a drag cup which is open at one end. Drag cup rotor mounted on the shaft made up of non-magnetic conducting material, shape of hollow cylinder with one side open. Hollow cylinder with one side open, and it is very thin and it should be light. Drag cup freely rotates in the air gap between the inner and stator cores, keeping the air gap minimum. Now we'll see the working principle. You can see the symbolic representation of a two-phase AC servo. This represents the rotor. It can be any one of the three types. Two windings, reference winding, where you provide a constant voltage, and here you are having the control winding. The phase difference should be 90 degree. For that, you can see a phase shifting capacitor present along with the reference winding. Single phase supply is provided. So working principle similar to that of ordinary induction motor. The reference winding is excited by a constant voltage source with a frequency between the range of 50 to 1000 Hz, and the control winding is fed through a servo amplifier and a modulator, and it is fed with a variable voltage. The control winding is fed with a variable voltage but of low frequency, and it can be of variable polarity also. Now 90 degree phase difference, as I told you, is obtained with the insertion of a capacitor, usually along with the reference winding. This results in exciting currents. There will be two currents, one flowing through the reference winding and the second flowing through the control winding, and they have a phase displacement of 90 degree, giving rise to a rotating magnetic field. Two currents which are out of phase will produce a rotating magnetic field, and the rest of the working principle is very similar to that of ordinary three-phase induction motor. Now speed or position control signal amplified with servo amplifier. We'll see the closed loop control system towards the end of this lecture, and the same is applied to the control winding. Speed is directly proportional to control voltage. Torque of the rotor is roughly proportional to the applied control voltage. The direction of rotation can be reversed by reversing the phase difference from leading to lagging or vice versa. You have seen the diagram. So it can be either VM angle 0 with VA angle 90 plus 90, or else you can have VM angle 0 with VA angle minus 90. Major power is supplied by the reference winding. Control winding provides less power, thus helps to reduce the size of the servo amplifier. Now you can see the schematic representation. This is how we represent a servo motor. Reference phase, VM angle 0. Control phase fed with VA angle plus 90 or minus 90, and this is the high resistance cage rotor. So this is the way we represent a two-phase AC servo motor. Now you have seen the relevance of high rotor resistance, and so this figure 8 shows the torque speed characteristics. A high rotor resistance ensures a negative slope over its entire operating range. Also the same provides positive damping for good stability too. So you can see VA1 greater than VA2, greater than VA3, and this is with VA equal to 0 passing through the origin. So linear characteristics, and that too with negative slope. Torque speed characteristics of a typical two-phase AC servo motor. Now applications of AC servo motors: used as instrument servos, used along with process controllers, extensively used in robotics, for self-balancing recorders, machine tools where precise angular motion is necessary, extensively used in aircraft and missile control system. Now servo motor, you can see the complete representation, block diagram of a complete servo system used in a closed loop control system. Figure shows an arrangement for closed loop control. can see the reference input is sent to the servo amplifier, which controls the speed of the motor. You can see the feedback mechanism. A feedback device is mounted onto the machine, which is either an optical encoder or a magnetic encoder. This device changes the mechanical motion into electrical signal and it is used as feedback. Now, this feedback is given to the error detector, which compares the actual operation with that of the reference input. Here there is a comparison taking place. If there is an error, that error is directly fed to the amplifier, which will be used to make necessary corrections in the control action. In many servo systems, both velocity and position are monitored. Servo motors can thus provide accurate speed, not alone speed, torque, and have ability for direction control. Now, the reference box, control system. Since servo motor is a control system motor, I have taken that topic, this particular topic, from Control Systems by A. Nagurkani. You can also refer AC and DC Machines Volume 2 by B.L. Tereja and A.K. Tereja. Electrical Machines by Ashwak Hussain. I have also referred to that book. And finally, The Theory and Performance of Electrical Machines by J.B. Gupta. Thank you.